So Matthias, Netic Health. So Matthias is in the MTM program. For those of you who don't know what that is, it's a master's in translational management, and it's joint between UCSF and Berkeley. His team is impressive. They've really worked well as a team. They've pivoted their idea and they're jumping onto the COVID telehealth opportunity. So by the way, I just heard today that the utilization of telehealth at UCSF has jumped from 2.5% to 55% since COVID started. So you're right, it's an opportunity. So tell us about it, Matthias, and unmute yourself. Great.
Hey everyone, let me quickly share my PowerPoint.
And while he's doing that, he said, I've been surprised by how a team from different backgrounds can have such valuable insights. Especially as a physician, you're taught to be very focused on a problem, which is why it is so helpful to have different backgrounds and opinions around you to open up your view on what is possible. I think it made me much more understanding of different views. So Matthias, show us what you've learned.
Hi everyone. So I'm Matthias, and we are Netic Health. We are a telemedicine company focused on physical therapy. Now, let me tell you about Amanda, whom I talked to very recently. So she's a very active person. She loves trail running and she loves all kinds of sports. And about like a month ago, she tore her ACL, had to go to physical therapy, got exercises on a sheet of paper, and then went to surgery. And afterwards, the shelter at home happens. A lot of physical therapy clinics all over the US closed down. And we still have patients like her that need to see a physical therapist, or they might have a lifelong effect on their knees. And so physical therapists at this point are also sitting at home trying to find patients, but the system is not working. So you have both of these groups sitting at home separately and no real way to connect them. What is very interesting though, is that COVID-19, as Stephanie said, is forcing everyone to move to telehealth. So even people who never treat a patient for physical therapy over telehealth have to learn that now. And so what we want to build is a telehealth physical therapy platform that connects patients, MPTs, and facilitate scheduling and billing, making it easy, making it very quick to get an appointment, to get reimbursed as a PT. Even though you have your own clinic, you can see a couple of patients on the side. And our long-term goal is not only to provide that interaction once a week with a physical therapy patient, but we want to create, using artificial intelligence and computer vision, a solution that works on smartphones that can track movements and can help people to do their exercises at home, even when they're not seeing a physical therapist. That was our original idea, but that's now moved to the future. So in the past 3 weeks, we have been building a website, and Stephen and Peter have been very good about this. So we could test this out with patients and physical therapists and ask their opinion. And then last weekend, Stephen at the MIT Hackathon dove into the depth of what should really the function be of these tools. And he has a background in digital health and telemedicine and compared several potential competitors more from the medical field to look what could this look like. And in the last 2 weeks, we've also been working with Nick outside of this class to create a high fidelity wireframe that we plan to implement in the coming weeks to be able to really start testing this with patients and PTs. So the business model is a two-sided business model, very similar to Airbnb, for example. What is very interesting, though, is that the average revenue that a patient gives to a PT per hour is around $125, and a PT usually only sees $40 of that money. All the rest is overhead that goes to the clinic. Now, what we want to do, we want to provide that virtual clinic and take a smaller fee, around 36%, for example, and so we could still maintain a healthy margin and do the reimbursement and make it very easy for the PTs. So the classical customer acquisition cost in this field is around $70 per patient, with an LTV around 270. Now, this is the classical physical therapy space, and we have yet to see how this changes in the upcoming digital health space. So the market size is $36 billion outpatient PT in the US. Orthopedics is half of that, and we are planning to target athletes, people who do sports, who want to see a PT once a week for their exercises and for their recovery. And those people, through our interviews, we found were most interested in adopting these technologies. But as I said, everybody will be forced to adapt these technologies. So everybody will learn to use them in the coming months. So the big competitors in the field are companies like Doxy.me and MedBridge that are really built into a physical PT clinic or Doxy to see patients that you're already seeing in your clinic, but there is no real way to get new patients. On the other hand, you have Luna, which is an on-demand physical therapy platform where you can find a PT to come to your home, but there the interaction is really physical. So we want to really combine both to find new patients and to also treat the patients online. The reason we're doing now is because the regulations are changing very rapidly because of COVID. They're less stringent. PTs can use non-HIPAA compliant tools until COVID ends to see their patients, so we can rapidly scale with an MVP instead of having to build everything out HIPAA compliant before we can start. Then reimbursement has been changing. They allow tele-rehabilitation to be reimbursed now, which is very interesting because that's the reason there are few competitors in this space. On the other hand, our long-term goal was creating this automated or assistive exercises at home from a smartphone device. And if we build this platform first, we don't need FDA approval because it will be physical therapists that provide the guidance and the recovery. So our roadmap really is to focus on launching that MVP, getting that customer feedback, and by Q3, be able to create a platform and start acquiring a partner from insurance companies, for example, to send patients our way when they don't know what to do with them. Then as COVID-19 subsides and we're all returning normal to lives and everybody can see a PT without risk of getting infected again, then we plan to start to transition to the computer vision R&D and afterwards really validating that we improve clinical outcomes with our technology. So this is the amazing team. Some of us have a background in digital health and telemedicine. Others are at the moment working on diagnostics at UCSF to try to help the COVID-19 crisis. And we have people with mobility expertise and a lot of physical therapy expertise on the team as well. We have had amazing advisors. Elise and Stephanie throughout this course have been giving great advice. And then Dan Burnett is also somebody who has advised me on more the medical and the regulatory side of things. He has a lot of experience in that field. Then in conclusion, so there is an unprecedented opportunity in telehealth, as we all know, but the space of physical therapy is relatively new, and that's why we want to dive right into it. We're building a double-sided marketplace, and long-term we plan to transition to these automated home exercises that patients can do on their own time. This is Netic Health. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Matthias. And I misspoke. MTM is Masters in Translational Medicine. I said it wrong. Yeah, it's a great program. Okay, judges.
I like the concept. The question early on is, how are you going to get to the physical therapists? You know, even approved principal. Do you have those connections?
Yeah, so we're building them. And we believe that getting the physical therapists early on is actually not a problem. We have a list of physical therapists online from the APTA you can find relatively easy. You can even find those who give telemedicine or allowing telemedicine tools online. And then every physical therapist we've talked to has only half of his workload or less. So people are at this moment very inclined to onboard in this type of solution.
I see. Thank you.
And any other questions? Okay. Yeah. Lynn.
Yeah, Matthias, you know, really like ortho as a space. I think there's a lot of waste in the system because of this. And I would assume, you know, PT, if you really go early in the consumer kind of clinical journey, if you will, there's a lot of cost savings that can come to that. Have you thought about kind of how you think about CAC and where you can kind of penetrate into the consumer patient journey earlier in the chain?
So yeah, we've been hearing about patients who've had injury, and that's a lot of sports people who don't really right away go to a physical therapist. We don't know exactly how to market to them. So that's something we want to explore And the first thing we're going to explore is the online to see if people look up for their symptoms, see if we can get them on board for a short introduction with a physical therapist.
Great. I think we'll stop there. And thank you, Matthias. And thank you, team. And let's